Good morning dear students, I am teaching chapter 2 and name of the chapter 2 is the components of food. And yesterday I discussed about diseases due to deficiency of proteins. So if proteins are not present in our diet, then which kind of diseases will happen? So you can see that proteins are called the bodybuilding foods, but if proteins are not present in our diet, then diseases like kwashiorkor and marasmus disease will occur in the body. You can see that diseases due to deficiency of proteins. Diseases due to deficiency of proteins. If proteins are not present in our diet, then which kind of diseases will occur? So first disease you can see that kwashiorkor and marasmus. Kwashiorkor and marasmus. Kwashiorkor and marasmus. So first I will tell you what are the symptoms of the kwashiorkor disease. So first symptoms is the protruding belly. Stomach is coming like that. This is the stomach is like that. Stomach part is coming out. So this is protruding belly. And second, you can see that second is the dark and scaly skin. So second is the dark and scaly skin. And third one, you can see that brownish hair. Hair is brown in color because proteins are the bodybuilding foods. But if protein are not in our diet, then diseases will happen like protruding belly, dark and scaly skin, brownish hair, stunted growth, usually underweight, stunted growth. Usually we can say that it is underweight, loss of appetite, anemia, mental retardation, means mentally they are not perfect, mental retardation, reduced resistance to diseases. So you can see that what are the symptoms of the kwashiorkor. Then I will tell you, first symptoms is a protruding belly. Belly is coming like that in this way. Dark and scaly skin, brownish hair. Skin is dark in color and brownish hair if proteins are not present in the diet. Then stunted growth, means usually we can say that they are underweight. Loss of appetite. Appetite that means hunger. Hunger. And anemia, blood loss. Blood is not present in the proper body, means deficiency of the blood. Mental retardation. Mentally they are not perfect. And reduced resistance to diseases because immune system are weak. If any child immune system are weak, they don't have capacity to fight against the diseases. Not only in case of child, if any adult one, if immune system will not be strong, they can't fight with any kind of diseases. But if our immune system will be strong, then we can fight the different kind of diseases. So protein is the bodybuilding food. When proteins are not present in the diet, then this kind of disease will happen. So these are the symptoms of the kwashiorkor. If any child is suffering from the kwashiorkor diseases, then these are the symptoms. You can see the symptoms diagram, you can see in the book, and while you will see the diagram, then you can understand the situation. And next I will tell you what are the symptoms of marasmus. Symptoms of marasmus. So first I will tell you symptom, what is the symptoms of the marasmus disease. First symptoms, you can see that poor muscles. Symptoms of the marasmus disease, these are the symptoms. Poor muscles development. Poor muscles development. You know that why food is important. You know that we are taking food for the health, for growing. So, and if we will not take the food in proper way, then our muscles will not be strong. So we can say that poor muscles development and bones showing through the skin. Means you can see the bones over the skin. Bones showing through the skin. These are the second symptoms those child are suffering from the marasmus. Bones showing through the skin. Means you can say that in other words, no fat. Bones showing through the skin. You can say that no fat. And weak legs. You can say that legs are very weak. Weak legs. Loss of appetite. Weak legs. And then you can say that loss of appetite. Anemia. Grossly underweight. You can see that grossly underweight. Grossly underweight. Grossly underweight. Mental retardation. Reduced resistance to diseases. Same way, mental retardation and reduced resistance to diseases. So these are the symptoms of the marasmus. If any child is suffering from the marasmus diseases, so you can say that first one is the poor muscles development. Means muscles are not developed properly and bones showing through the skin. You can see the bones through the skin. Means no fat. In other words, you can say that it no fat. And weak legs. Legs are very weak. And loss of appetite. Means hunger. Loss of hunger. And anemia. Loss of blood. Grossly underweight. According to the age, they are underweight. And mental retardation, mentally they are not perfect. And reduced resistance to diseases. They don't have, means their immune system is not very strong. They are less strong. So these are the, I think all of you understood about the kwashiorkor diseases and about the marasmus diseases. So symptoms I told you, first symptoms, what are the symptoms of the kwashiorkor and marasmus. So symptoms I told you. Then kwashiorkor and marasmus diseases are diseases which is result from PEM. PEM is a protein energy malnutrition. So I will tell you what is the PEM, protein energy malnutrition. You can see that protein energy malnutrition. Protein energy malnutrition. What is the protein energy malnutrition? protein, energy, malnutrition. This is the PEM. Protein, energy, malnutrition. So, table 2.4 gives the deficiency diseases caused by various vitamins. And vitamins are required in the small quantities for proper functioning of our bodies. Means vitamins are required in the very small quantity. And it vitamins help in the keeping our eyes, bones, teeth and gums healthy. So what is the protein energy malnutrition? Protein energy malnutrition is the term to describe which lack proteins and energy giving carbohydrates. Which lack proteins and energy giving carbohydrates. Diseases caused by PEM are common among the children. So these are the diseases which is caused by deficiency of proteins and deficiency of the carbohydrates. So this is called a protein energy malnutrition. And why should we eat polished rice and wheat flour? Because much of the food we eat, it is processed. And polished rice and wheat flour, that is the maida, are the example of the processed foods. And processing removes the many of the vitamin B, and beriberi is caused by the vitamin B1. Diseases, beriberi, and it is caused by the deficiency of vitamin B1. We should try to eat foods that are not processed or polished, because it is lack the vitamin, name is the B1, and if B1 is not present in the diet, then we will suffer from the diseases, and disease name is the beriberi. And diseases due to deficiency of minerals. If mineral are not present in the diet, then different kinds of diseases are there. I will tell you first. If vitamin B1 is not in the diet, vitamin B1 is not present in the diet, then they will suffer from the diseases. Disease name is the beriberi. Disease name, what is the disease name? Disease name is the beriberi. So today I discussed about diseases due to deficiency of proteins, kwashiorkor, marasmus. Then I told you protein energy malnutrition, PEM, and I told you diseases due to deficiency of vitamins. So all of you take revision till here, and when vitamin B1 are not present in the diet, then the disease is the beriberi, and all of you take revision till here.